Creating good code is hard work. So one of the solutions to avoid this hard work is by creating reusable code. This might be code that you yourself have created before, or it might be code that's been created by someone else. So for the next part of this lesson, we're going to be talking about ways to create and use reusable code. And we'll start at the lowest level, which is functions. A function basically defines a block of reusable code. I like to think of a function as like a machine that has an input and an output. The stuff that you put into the machine is called the argument. The thing that comes out of the machine is called the returned value. And the way that you write a function in code generally is that you have the name of the function, parentheses, and then you have a list of all the things that are going to go in separated by columns. These are the arguments. And then if the function produces output, which usually they do, that function output can be either printed directly on the screen or it can be assigned to a variable. So in this example here, we are imagining a function called make latte, which does the job of making lattes. And the arguments or the things that we're passing into the latte making machines would be beans, milk, and water. Then the output will be assigned into another variable that we're going to call my latte. So the idea here is that when you are creating a function, the name of the function should tell you something about what the function does. And we also follow the same strategy on naming variables. The variable names we would like to say something about what the object is. Functions can come from three different places. There can be functions that are built in to the language itself. There are also functions that you've created and defined in your own code. And then there are also functions that have been defined by somebody else in what is known as a module. So the circumstances where you want to use a function, essentially anytime you want to use code more than once, it's probably worth putting it into a function. If you're using a function of somebody else's, you don't necessarily have to have any idea how the function works. All you have to do is to have a clear understanding of what you have to put in the function, in other words, the arguments, and what kind of thing you should expect to come out of the function, if anything. As I said, the function may not have any arguments. There's nothing that needs to go in. It just puts something out. Sometimes you put things in and it doesn't have a return value. It just does something. So nothing actually comes out. There's an action instead. The thing that's great about functions is they really help us leverage the power of open source coding. And they're the main way that we are able to use other people's code, and also to make code that we've created be available to others. Functions also keep the language lean by not providing every possible capability. By now, Python and R have so much code written that if the language itself included all of that reusable code, they would be too big even to load. And so it was a conscious decision to not try to put everything into these languages, but rather to only put the basic parts in and then allow users to import the additional parts that they need. So if you've ever waited for something like ArcGIS or Photoshop to load, it takes a long time because all of the functionality has to get loaded at once. And you'll notice that Python and R load relatively quickly for that reason. So we've already actually been using two of the built-in functions that are a part of Python, the input function, which allows us to say what the message is and then take input from the person. And then the print function, which takes the string or number that we pass into it as an argument and then prints it onto the screen. So we're going to look at an example of a function that I've defined myself called reverse names. So let's just go to this Jupyter notebook. So in my literate coding here, the first thing I've done is explained about what the function does. So this is the definition of the function. As you can see, there's a lot of code here. But as I said, we don't really even have to understand what the code does. We don't have to understand how the code works. All we have to know is what it does. So I've set up here that what you need to do is to pass in the last name first, separated by a comma from the first name. And then if there's a suffix like junior or the third, you can include that separated by a comma. And then what you expect to get out of the function is the name string reversed into the normal thing, the normal pattern that we are used to seeing here. When you define a function, you only have to do that one time. And essentially when you define a function, so I'm going to go ahead and run that, what you've done is taken that code and made it available to the environment of your system. So now at any point in the future, if I want to use the function reverse names, my environment now knows what that function is. So I have here a very tiny little script. The first line basically asks me what is the name and lets me type it in, and then assigns that to the variable called backwards name. Then I take whatever is in the backwards name variable and pass it into the reverse names function. That function is going to switch the name parts around into the proper order. And then the output of the function is, the returned output is going to be assigned then to a variable called corrected name. And then the variable we will print to see what it looks like on the screen. So let's go ahead and run this. So let's say, so I put a first name, a last name, and a suffix. I will hit enter, and it's turned it around into the proper order. Now, if I want to use the function again, I don't have to go back up here and rerun the code that defines the function because my environment already knows what that function is. All I have to do is just run that code again. Let's try. Franklin Smith III. Okay, and this function also will handle names that are not reversed as long as they don't have any commas in them. So as you can see, we don't really have to know anything about how the function works itself. All we have to know is what we need to put into the function and what we can expect to get out.